Let's take a look at some notable improvements in the November update. This is not going to be a full list of all the improvements. I'll just be doing a quick run through of three updates that I think will be useful in the design environment. Under the fillet command, there is a new asymmetric radius type. This is very similar to the tool distance option for chamfer. With this option, you are able to adjust the edge offset on either side of the fillet. A new type of assembly constraint has been added, and that is the center constraint. There is already a coincident constraint between the base of this bar and the top face of the slot. We want to center this bar within the width of this slot. Go to Example, Constraint Components. For Type, select Center. For Position Mode, select Between Two Faces. Select these two faces of the slot. Followed by these two faces of the bar. This creates an equal gap on either side of the bar. For me, the next feature here is the most satisfying update, and that has to do with Sketch Auto Constraint. When Sketch Auto Constraint first came out not too long ago, it did not really add constraints and was pretty poor at recognizing design intent. I'm glad to say that this has been massively improved. Suppose that I am trying to draw this shape. This consists of a horizontal line, a 3-point arc tangent at these points, and a line at an angle. This is meant to be a closed profile. Let's start with the horizontal line. Normally, the program will assist you to snap to the horizontal by showing you the constraint as you extend the line. Suppose that I make a mistake and end up with a line that is slightly off by a degree. Now, let's draw the other line. I will snap it to this point and end it somewhere here. Next, let's draw the 3-point arc. I will snap the start point to this end of the line. You should see a square when you snap. For the end point, suppose that I slip up and do not snap successfully, but I still end up close to the end point of the line. You can extend out the arc until it is tangent to this line. For the purposes of demonstration, let's pull back a little. Go to Constraints, Auto Constraint. Scroll all the way down to the bottom. You will see a Modify Geometry option. Click on that. You can see that the system picks up on your design intent and solves the three problems in the sketch. It has made this line horizontal. It has joined the arc to this line. At the same time, it has added a tangent constraint at both ends of the arc. You have the ability to adjust the tolerances involved for each of these types of constraints. In this case, only lines within a 3-degree deviation from the horizontal will be made horizontal. Only points within this distance from each other will be joined automatically. There is also a tolerance slider to adjust all parameters universally. As I slide to the left to make the criteria more stringent, I start to lose constraints. If you slide it all the way to the left, the system will assume that those are not mistakes and will add in dimensions accordingly. Let's bring it back to the previous tolerance and confirm. This is now a closed profile. If we hover over this point, you can see that a coincident constraint has been added. Alright, hope that this has been helpful. Do try out the new updates and let me know your thoughts.